Welcome back. Well, 200 top military leaders have left their ranks during President Obama's time in office so far, averaging one every 8.8 days. So is the military being decimated under the Obama administration?
It is pretty amazing when a group of generals say to themselves, I don't know why this guy isn't listening to us. I don't know what we're going to do about it, but we have to do something about it. Because in America, when you become the head general, or you even take the oath of office in any serious office, it's not to the president, it's to the Constitution. They were acting on behalf of what they thought the country should be doing. And so that was the leverage they used, I think, to make this extraordinary decision that they're gonna work with other people to help out, or at least to give Bashar the intelligence he needs to survive. Why we would want in the United States for Bashar not to survive, given the consequences of having, let's say, the Islamic State or al-Nusra or groups allied with them with the same point of view run a country with bordering on Iran and Israel. I mean, my God, that would be a formula for complete chaos, as we have in Libya. It just makes no sense. I do know that the intelligence that was produced, the report I mentioned in the article, the assessment, the major sort of assessment that included everything from satellite and human intelligence and intercepts, a hot report, was certainly given to the White House. I have no way of explaining why the White House wasn't interested in that intelligence. I mean, come on. They know that these groups, that they're at least at some level, they understand that the groups they insist are so moderate have a lot of ties. You can't exist without being in league with al-Nusra or the Islamic State. You know, actually, the article is really not about what I'm saying. It's about what the military said. It's what about a bunch of generals working, you know, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs and the head of the Defense Intelligence Agency, just feeling confounded about the fact that they're reporting all this stuff. There's no moderates. The moderates don't really exist. That you have to deal with Russia. That you have to stop talking about getting rid of Assad, because that's just crazy, given what happened in Libya when you got rid of Gaddafi. Look what happened in Iraq when you got rid of Saddam. Actually, if I'm Putin looking at it, I'm thinking, we're supposed to be in the same bed in terms of fighting international terrorism. We're all secular countries who believe in freedom of religion. And here we are. The United States has done what since 9/11? They've knocked off a secular guy in Iraq. They've knocked off a secular guy in Libya, and they're trying their best to make trouble for a secular guy in Syria.